Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. So we are smack dab in the middle of winter and it is freezing out today. I don't know, can you see that? You can actually see my breath in here. So the heater hasn't been turned on for that long, but I wanted to talk to you guys about self-heating lithium batteries. Cold streak in Alberta is temperatures around minus 30 and they feel like minus 40. Right now it is currently minus 28, feels like minus 35. We get asked this all the time. It's like, how do you guys stay warm in your camper van? How do your electronics work? How does your battery still work at this temperature? Well, to be honest, electronics in cold weather just don't work great together. They just don't perform as well as they normally would. Because we have a self-heated lithium battery, that makes things so much easier. How do you guys actually like stay warm when you go outside? Well, let me show you. Yeah, that's right. The temperature dips, the beaver comes out. I'm not actually sure if this is real fur because I didn't buy it, but we're gonna go ahead and assume it is not. Right there, that's how we stay warm when we go outside. Back to cold weather batteries. The reason why you need a self-heated battery or you need to heat your lithium battery is because the reaction created in the battery is molecular. When temperature dips, those atoms aren't moving around as much as they normally would, banging off each other. So they are just sitting there and basically vibrating and not causing the reaction that it would normally cause. That is kind of a quick sum up. Battleborn has actually done a really good comparison online that goes over lead acid versus lithium. I will link it below in the description if you would like to read that. It goes into the Peukert effect. I have my phone here because I want to get this exactly right. It is a mathematical equation that says if you have a high current coming out of the battery, you get less energy coming out of the battery. To simplify that a little bit, as you increase the discharge rate, you decrease the capacity. You are not going to get as much power out of your batteries as you normally would. And of course, lithium operates a lot better than lead acid, but the disadvantage is with lithium, it needs to be around 0 degrees Celsius to accept a charge. If you try to charge a lithium battery lower than 0 degrees Celsius, say at minus 10, minus 20, you can do significant damage to the battery. So that is why it is important to have a self-heated battery or have your batteries located in a heated compartment. Today, I wanted to talk about three of the most popular heated batteries on the market. That is Battleborn, Renogy, and my favorite, Canbat. So there are a few differences between these batteries that I'm gonna go over and help you figure out which one you should buy. First up, I'm gonna talk about Renogy. They just came out with a self-heated battery and I haven't personally been able to test it out, but I have tested out their other batteries and I've also reviewed them. Their internal heater works by taking power from the battery itself, heating it up to 0 degrees Celsius. Battleborn has a similar battery that works the same way. It also takes power from the battery itself and uses that to heat the battery up to 0 degrees Celsius so it can receive a charge. Battleborn's battery actually comes with a switch that you're able to shut on and off and also a wire on top that you can disconnect the heater. During the summer months when it's warm, you want to just disconnect it, not to worry about it. During the winter, you're going to want to be able to flick that switch when it dips far below 0 degrees Celsius to make sure that battery is heated. Luckily, all three of these batteries have a battery management system or BMS inside that will actually shut off the charging so the battery doesn't get damaged below 0 degrees Celsius. I'm not sure what the actual temperature, it might vary a little bit from battery to battery, but regardless, below 0 degrees Celsius or somewhere around there, the battery will actually shut itself down so it doesn't get damaged, which is a great feature. Canbat's battery works a little bit different from the other two and is why we bought one and why I wanted to get one. Instead of taking charge from the battery itself, the battery will actually take charge from the charging source. So whether that's your solar panels, your alternator, or shore power, it will take power from that source, heat itself up, and then start absorbing that charge once it hits above 0 degrees Celsius. As far as cost goes, Renogy is going to be the cheapest out of the three by quite a bit. What you are saving in money, you are losing with customer service, unfortunately. The international customer support for Renogy hasn't been the best. I've experienced it. I've heard other people who've experienced it. They do make great products. In the States, I've heard it's better, but that is what you're sacrificing with a cheaper product. As far as Canbat and Battleborn go, their products are just over $1,000 for a 100 amp hour heated battery. About $1,050, I'm talking in American dollars. The thing with Battleborn is they have free shipping to the lower 48 states, but outside of that, you're gonna be paying for shipping. And of course, batteries aren't the lightest thing out there, so that is gonna be a little more expensive. Canbat batteries actually have free shipping to the States and Canada, which is really nice, especially if you're Canadian. They are a Canadian company out of Vancouver, Canada, and their customer service is phenomenal. I've also heard really good thing about Battleborn's customer service. They really know what they're talking about and have fantastic support. Canbat also makes lead acid batteries as well as lithium batteries. They come in all different sizes and also different voltages like 12 volt, 24 volt, 48 volt. So they offer a ton of different products. Both Battleborn and Canbat only specialize in batteries. So that is all they offer. That is what they do, and they are fantastic at it. Whereas Renogy obviously makes all sorts of different solar components. Canbat is also a distributor of Victron products. And if you have done any research at all, you know that Victron has a fantastic reputation in the solar market and they make great products. If you guys are new and designing your own solar system, I've developed a simple solar guide. I will link it below. It covers everything from component breakdown to a schematic diagram, as well as a price and quantity chart with links and discount codes. So if you would like to learn more about solar systems and are a little confused about what's going on and need some help, I will link that below. It's only $14.99. I've also had lots of good feedback, so be sure to check that out. I will also link all of these batteries in the description below if you want to go ahead and check them out. With Renogy and Canbat, if you use the discount code MADE2TRAVEL at checkout, you will receive a 5% discount, which is really nice since batteries are probably going to be one of the most, if not the most expensive component in your camper van or solar system. We have been using our Canbat battery for the last year and a half and it has performed flawlessly. It is always charged up and ready to go. In our last van, we rented out before building this one, they had a lead acid battery, I believe. I think it was 100 amp hours and it just did not perform well at all. Our fridge was always dying. It wasn't even that cold when we rented the van. I think it was around the end of March. We were doing a ski trip through British Columbia and it just kept dying. So we weren't sure what was going on, but it definitely wasn't charging properly. It just wasn't operating as well. Lithium definitely has the upper hand if you guys don't already know that. There are also a few ways that you can charge batteries if you don't want to buy a heated one, of course. You can buy temperature regulated heat mats, or you can build an insulated enclosure to put your batteries in. Our batteries are located by the back of the van, completely opposite of the heater. It stays quite cold down there on the ground close to the back doors. So quite often actually, it can be 5 to 10 degrees colder underneath the bed back there since heat just rises up. That's one thing to keep in mind as well. I wouldn't try some of the heated pads. They can be a little cheap and a little finicky, and the last thing you want to do is overheat your battery and damage it. The components in there can be somewhat fragile, so you don't want to cause a fire or light anything up. All right, thank you guys so much for watching. If you have any questions regarding self-heated batteries, comment below. Let me know what's going on. If you're considering buying one of these batteries, also let me know which one you decide to go with. I'd love to hear from you. Be sure to like and subscribe and hit that bell for notifications because we are going to be posting a video every single week. All right, I gotta get going. Look at that, so cold. Woo-hoo. Wow. Okay, see you guys in the next one.